Okay, hi everybody. This is Crypto Blade Noob. Okay, this is my day 6 playing the game, and then I have read up a lot about this game, and then I'll try to share some insights from the white paper and also different information from different sources. So I think it will be very important that we know this kind of combat variation, so to optimize our actually earning. So how, what is this, what I'm going to cover today about this combat variable is like how you meet, what kind of enemies you meet, like say the four combat variables, what determines the combat, and then there is this very complicated formula that, I mean, everybody has seen it, and also the type of elemental matching, how can the elements actually interact in this game. Also, what is unaligned character power? Okay, and then actually, after some research, I realized that the unaligned character power is the one that determines our matching phase. And later, I'll demonstrate like what is actually the matching phase, and also the aligned character power, and what is this aligned character power, and then the combat phase, and what is it? What is the combat phase actually? Okay, how to determine the weapon, the power of the weapon, and how high or how low, or whether how to determine what is a good weapon and what weapon you should use. And then after that, we revisit this complicated formula, and then we will do some actual battles in this video to show something, to demonstrate something. So first, the first four combat variables. So that in this Crypto Blade game, okay, all the coin and all the sword and all the characters are actually NFT. And then here, every there will be these things that determine all the battles. So the first thing that affect the battles is how we match, how the game actually assign us the enemies, and when is this unaligned power and this matching phase occur. So for example, let me change to a character with stamina. Okay, so here I have some stamina here. So when do we when is this unaligned character power being calculated? So this unaligned character power is being calculated when we select the weapon. So the moment you click onto a weapon, they're actually calculating all the power and then multiply by your character's power. So I'm here's a level 21 character, so 3600 power. And then they will multiply this with the weapon multiplier, and then they will match you with an enemy. So when they match you with an enemy, then you will get this set. So if I were to change a weapon, then look, if I change a weapon, then I will have a different, I will have a different stats, then therefore they will give me a different different batch of enemies based on this weapon. So there will be it will be elaborated later, okay, how this matching phase is being calculated. So each different weapon, the matching phase occur when we click onto the weapon, and then you bring us to the sets of enemy that we can get. So then we have this aligned character power. So this aligned character power is the one that when we actually click the fight button, like for example here, there's nothing I want to fight with this weapon. Okay, I go to this weapon. So if I want to fight, the in this combat phase is where they calculated where they calculate our aligned character power. So it take into account elements. So later we'll elaborate on what does this mean. Okay, so if we were to fight, so the moment we press the fight button and do the transaction, what they are actually doing is they are actually matching and then determine the victory already. So this combat phase is actually determining who is winning or who is losing by calculating your true power. Okay, that is that means the attributes are involved. And when we talk about attributes are involved, what attributes are involved, what kind of attributes? So there's this thing called the trait bonus. And what kind of trait bonus are there? There are three different kinds of trait bonus. Later I will also explain what three kinds and what are their significance. Okay, then the less, not less, I mean this is actually the most important, the enemy power. So the value that you see is actually how much you earn. Okay, and how much you really earn. There is a formula to show, and then I will also show you a way to back calculate and know the, because in Crypto Blade, there is a price oracle who changes the rate that they pay out. and then a portion of the payout is based on the enemy power. So if we know we can back calculate this payout, we can maybe make better decision on whether we want to fight a stronger enemy or fight a weaker enemy for a more higher chance of victory. Yeah, so but at current phase, because the gas fee rebate is actually a lot, so usually most people's optimized strategy is to fight something that is easy so that they get a guaranteed victory. Yeah, but maybe in the future, like say maybe BNB and transaction cost increases such that maybe it is not worth to always contest weak enemy anymore. We need to optimize our way to actually earn more, because if we always pick the weakest enemy, we might not be able to win. Like for example, if we get an enemy that's 28 28 28 and then 32, I mean, we could beat that 32, yeah, but if we chose for the 28, we are actually wasting a lot of opportunity costs. We could have actually earned more, but then when we choose a 28 XP, and then we get lesser out of it. I mean, when we know that we can actually beat the 32 at 90%+, I mean, we can use the simulator, I mean, yeah, then you will be able to calculate that and then optimize your payout. But how do we like choose weapon? And okay, so we go on to the next page. So how is this complicated formula going to work? Like what determines your roll? For example, when we fight, we say, you see, you roll a number and the enemy roll a number. So how is this roll being determined? So this is what we call the hero roll, is our roll. So it is affected by the weapon power multiplied by the hero power, then plus weapon bonus, plus minus 10%. So this is the RNG part, the random number generator. So if you are lucky, you roll a high, or sometimes you might see that you contest a very weak enemy and you still lose. And that would be probably you are very unlucky and you get a minus 10% and the enemy get a plus 10%. Okay, then there is this bonus, trait bonus, which is like the elemental bonus. So the three way of interaction is, okay, if you and your weapon matches, like for example, that means a fire character holding a fire weapon, that will give you, so this number here was 0.07, so this is actually a decimal, okay, so this is actually 0.0075, so these are 7.5% bonus. So the two things that you can control very easily is matching your character with a matching weapon, which is why in my Excel sheet, I always match an earth team with all the earth weapons. So this is something that you can control easily. And then the next one is, if you are advantage, you have an advantage over the enemy. For example, you are a fire character and then you target, you choose a earth enemy, and then that will give you another 7.5. so this 7.5 is very significant. So for example, we say the base is 100, we say this is us, and then this is the enemy. Okay, we both have 100, and then after that, after we say we get a bonus, we are 115, and then they are still 100. So the likelihood of us having a victory will be much higher. And then so how we get the different enemies is through, actually later I will share how the enemy power is determined. Actually, the enemy power is determined by us. Okay, that is what we'll cover later. So we just focus on this part first. So what is weapon power? Weapon power is actually the multiplier on your weapon. So the lousiest 1-star sword will give you a multiplier of 1.01 times, which is almost no bonus. And then the best 5-star sword, what is the best 5-star sword? I will explain later. It will give you a 4.21 multiplier. So then this number will be multiplied to your hero power. So what is your hero power? So your hero power, you can actually see your hero power here. Okay, this hero power here increases a lot as you level every 10 levels. So there is a formula for it. You can share. We'll share it later. Yeah. So we can see this. 3600 is our hero power. So how we can actually calculate this is 3600 multiplied by our weapon power. So in typically a 3-star weapon will be 1.5 times. Okay, 1.5 to 2 times, and then 1.5 to 2 times attack power, and then a 4-star could be somewhere between 2.5 a good one will be 2.5 to almost 3 is the perfect. And then so there is a different multiplier that we can calculate. So I will share how to do the actual calculation later as well. Then our hero power is actually this formula that I use, which is 1000 plus, actually E3 is the level. So the level minus 1 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 1 plus floor of this thing. So what does floor do? So the floor, if I my level minus 1 divided by 10, they will round down. So for example, if I'm level 10, 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 divided by 10 is 0.9. So 0.9, they will always round down. So it'll be 0. So we miss out this portion of the bonus. So that's why every 10 level, when you see when there's your level 11, 11 minus 1 divided by 10 will give you a 1. So then you will get benefit from this portion of the equation. So your attack power will spike every 10 level. Yeah, so that's the explanation. And then the character power per level is given here. So as we increase our level, our power will increase by a lot. And then what is weapon bonus? So weapon bonus is actually related to forging. And then now there is the forging event. But personally, I think it is not worth to actually do forging. It's actually too expensive. It's better that you just get a better 3-star or 4-star weapon, because forging can be really, really expensive. And the benefit is very little. Because for forging of weapon, you can look at the formula here. Weapon power multiplied by hero power. And then you add the weapon bonus. How insignificant is this? For example, if you burn until like for example, you can low burn up to a limit of say, so imagine you do a low burn of 100 upon 100, you will get a power of, you will get 1500 attack power. So this is the formula, 15 per low burn. At 100 for 100, you get 1500 power. But if your weapon bonus, I say you get a decent 3-star or 4-star weapon, a decent 4-star weapon, you get a 2.5 times multiplier. So we say this is weapon 2.5. And then your hero is at a high level. Say we don't say high, we say something achievable. Most people will be around 11 to 21. So this is a power at 21. We say 3600 after like less than 3 or 4 days of proper playing, you should reach this level. So this is our character power. Okay, so actually, we will notice that, okay, this part will be equals to this multiplied by this. So we actually have 9000 already. This 1005 is actually very insignificant. For example, if you just change to a slightly better weapon, now our power increases by a lot. Which is in fact from, say, let's go to this. So say if we get a average 4-star weapon, this okay 4-star around 4-star, and then say this is a good weapon, good 4-star. Actually, that's the best 4-star. Just for example, okay, just say 2 and 3. So this is the amount of gain you can get from a average 4-star to a good 4-star weapon. Yeah, and then you look at the amount that you can gain. I mean, you are better off buying upgrade your 3-star to a 4-star, or maybe even upgrade your 4-star to a 5-star, because that gives you a lot more gain compared to this 1500. Because this is just adding 1500 to this, and this low burn effect, forging effect, is even worse at higher level. For example, if we continue, let's say, okay, now we are higher level. We say now we are level 31. Okay, so level 31 with a good sword, or level 41 with a good sword. So at level, this is okay, so let's just say our level. And then here, this is our is level 21, level 21, and then this is level 31, level 41, and then here this will be what we call the weapon. Okay, we say weapon. This is maybe a 3-star. No, 3-star is not so okay. 4-star. We say this is a good 4-star. Okay, a good 4-star. In fact, this is the best a 4-star can get. A 3-star multiplier is the maximum that a 4-star can get. So for example, if you get a very, very good 4-star, you will get a 3x multiplier, and then this is the, this is your so-called combined, let's say combined power. So you will have a 21,000 power, and then this is a flat 1,005. This is from 4G. So now at very low level, beginner will feel like, oh, 4G make me a lot stronger, because why? This is a, let me delete away the PWR so I can make it into a formula. Yeah, so 4G gives you in terms how much power, raw power is here. So the amount that you gain is actually a lot. You see, you get a 20% gain when you are low level with a lousy weapon. But as you progress in the game, you realize, oh, it's only 7%. Yeah, so it's only 7% at mid game or end game level. This is not cheap to forge a weapon. If you notice, the forging weapon part is not cheap, because if you will try to forge a weapon, like for example, you choose a weapon and you try to reforge it, there is a reforging charge, which is 0.03 skill, and this 0.03 skill is actually around at current price $4 or $5. And then that will cost you 50 times in the event, 50 times $3, $100 over, not including the weapon that you need to burn. So inclusive of all the weapon that you need to burn, actually forging 2005 for say eventually 10% gain will cost you it will take you like say I would say $500 to actually get this 9% gain, which is very insignificant. So it's only for people who want to show off their weapons or boost. I mean, ultimately it is still worth to forge a little bit. Like for example, maybe we don't go to forge to 100, maybe make use of the event, we can do a forging to say LB30, because at LB30 maybe we still get a very good gain at a very reasonable price. Yeah, so maybe it's up to individuals to decide how much you want to do your forging. So continue. This bonus, and then yeah, let's move on to the weapon power. So there is a weapon power. So this weapon power, how is this weapon power being determined? So if we look at this, weapon power is stats 1 times n, stats 2 times n, stats 3 times n. So there's this n value here, which is 0.0025. So we can go to our this weapon, and then we just look at for example, say this weapon is a matching element. We can say it's a plus 295. So what is plus 295? How many percent? Actually, if you mouse over, you can see a 78.75. That is actually the multiplier. So we can go to our Excel. Okay, we get 295, and then there is a 3N value. So there is if this is of a matching element, 0.02675, and then we just power, it will be 0. Let me do the decimal place. Never mind, let's just, so for 575, so how to, let me try and get rid of this. Yeah, okay, so this is our lightning sword. Okay, so this, there will be three values here. So how we actually determine the power is, if we are a matching element, in this case, this matching element, okay, we have 295. So imagine if you are a matching element, so we say, okay, the percentage. So what is this percentage? Okay, the percentage will be equals to this, because this is matching. So there's three values if we are matching. If we are power is a universal That means it matches with all the elements, but the downside is for example, if you are using this matching is not to the weapon, it's actually to the character, not the weapon. For a lightning character, of course a lightning character will be the one using the lightning sword, unless you are stupid, okay? No offense, but a lightning character, this lightning weapon is not the lightning sword, it is a lightning character. So a lightning character will, using this sword, will actually get a bonus. So if a lightning character holding this sword and is matching, I will get this amount, 0.789. And then you go to mouse over, you see 78.75%, which is 78.9, the approximate percentage that you get. That is the bonus. So for example, we go to another weapon, a lightning character. Okay, now this sword is plus 363 power. So what is 363 power? 363 power, and then the percentage will be this multiplied by this, 93%. So obviously this weapon is a lot better than this weapon, because what does this percentage means? Okay, this need to multiply by 100. So this is a 78%, this is a 93%, you can put here 93%, okay. So actually the multiplier, how the formula works is, okay, our multiplier is 1 plus this percentage. So this one will, the multiplier of my weapon will be 1.78, and then 1.79, okay. And then the multiplier for my second weapon will be a 1.93. So that's how we get the multiplier. So this is the so-called weapon multiplier that we are talking about previously. This weapon multiplier. So a 3-star, a lousy 3-star, or say not lousy, a decent 3-star and a good 3-star is around 1.8 and 1.9. Yeah. So if we have something that is not matching, like for example this sword here. So this sword here, we have a total of 534 that is non-matching, and then the multiplier will be this value multiplied by this value multiplied by 100. We get 133%. If you look at this, 78 plus 55, this is our percentage that we get for this weapon. So, and then the multiplier here will be a 2.335. So this is a lousy 4-star. Say this is a lousy 4-star, which is 2. Okay, this is very lousy. This is a mid-tier 4-star. I mean, after all, it's my weapon, right? I choose something. This is very bad. Average should be around 2.5, but I crafted this and lazy to sell it. So yeah. So this is a lousy, below average, I would say 2.5 is the average. So try to get something that is higher attack. So that is how we actually do. But in certain cases, there will be like say multiple attributes. Like for example, let me go to this account one, and then we go to this sword. So this is a very good example that we can look at. So it has it is a earth, and then my earth character will be using it. So we have a matching stats, a non-matching stats, and power, which is a semi-matching. So how do we calculate for this kind of weapon? So we have the same thing. So we remove this. So we have a matching that is 391, a power that is 392, and then a non-matching, which is 327. So you look at the percentage. So here, this is a 104.5, and then the power 100.75 here, and then the last one, the fire, is 81.75. So we will add these three all up. So we say equal. Yeah, so this is going to be 278 extra percentage. So the multiplier for this weapon is 3.873. So this is actually one of the very good weapon that I luckily crafted. Okay, so This is very, very good. I will explain why. Not just because it has very high multiplier, but because the two high row is on the earth stats and also the power stats, and both of them are above 100%. And it's very important for these two stats, relevant stats, to be high. I will explain it why later and next time. So yeah, this is actually a rather good weapon. So yeah, this is in fact the best weapon that I have, and I was really lucky to get this. Yeah, so moving on, we go back to this formula. So this is how this M actually works, this 0.675, and then how we can actually find the multiplier for our weapon. And what is the best weapon? 4.21 times the best 5 star. The best 5 star will be something like this. So the best 5 star, for example, a fire sword plus 400 fire plus 400 fire plus 400 fire. So this is in theory the best available sword that you can get. So you will get $300 and this. So you become a 4.13 times. That's your multiplier. And here is, they say it's 4.2 lah, so it's about the same. Yeah, so that is the, because this is 400, yeah. Well, this becomes 400. This sword will give you a sum of 321 extra percentage, which is 1 plus 3.21, which gives you a 4.21 multiplier. So that is the best so-called 5-star weapon that anyone can ever roll. A fire sword with fire, all 400. So that is the perfect sword. Okay, moving on to the three different types of element. So here in the white paper, they mentioned matching element is not is important for win rate and experience. It's not important for the enemy power range, is not important for calculating pay. Why is that so? Because the matching element take place, they doesn't, so is the part that I mentioned about the matching the aligned and the unaligned character. So here the matching phase is important, and then for you to matching it's important to get a higher win rate to earn more money. Okay, because the game will never throw you a ridiculous monster that it's not supposed to throw you a ridiculous monster just because you are fire, and then they will give you a very strong earth. No, so they will be fair, so you can actually be smart and fight the earth and then get the advantage. So the game will not be ridiculous to give you an extremely high monster. So they will ensure that you will have a chance to beat the monster somehow. So matching does not affect the payout. That means that if I use a weakness and to kill another monster, it don't really affect the payout. But however, if you fight something, for example, if I were to fight something that is my weakness, I will go for like higher difficulty. For example, something that is like giving me 31 and 32 experience, that is very high, I will be able to beat that kind in a weakness condition. So there's a rule of thumb. Okay, so if I have advantage, this is just a general guideline. Spelling. Okay, I have advantage. I will go for what? I will go for anything from 32, 30, 31. So if we have an advantage element, so we have an elemental advantage, we'll go for the 32 experience, 31, and anything below that. 33 can be risky. I will explain why, because in this game they always round down the value. A 33, sometimes you can beat a 33 because it's a 33.0 or 33.1, but sometimes at 33.8, 33.9, they will also show as 33. They will not round up. This game always round down. So sometimes the 33 is a 33.9, and then that will be very difficult. You will be able to find it through the simulator online, but yeah, if you want to do it fast, try not to go for something that is 33 because you don't know if it's 33.1 or 33.9 unless you use a simulator. Yeah. So in general, when I'm fighting something that is to do it quickly, I just do something that's 30, 31. And for neutral enemy, I will try to do 29 and 28. Or any, there's nothing lesser. The lowest you can get is 28. Unless sometimes you will see a 27. Okay. Very rare cases. Okay, then I'll explain how you can meet the 27. Okay, but yeah, that will be another time. Okay, so here I will just say try to fight something that is in this range. You have advantage, you try 31, 32 to gain more profit. And then if you have no choice, if you want to go for neutral, try to go 28, 29. 30 is a little bit risky, and here 33 is a little bit risky. I'll try to avoid that. This is my usual, I will go for something that is 30, 31, 31, 32 if I have advantage, and 28, 29 if I am neutral. Okay, so the few interaction here is that we can have a fire character holding a fire weapon, that's a 7.5, and then a fire character fighting an earth, 7.5, important, and then that's not a fire, so actually this is a fire character having a fire stats. Yeah, so that is also you will also get some advantage. Yeah, because like if you are a fire character holding a fire, you get the higher this roll, which is a 0.002675 instead of just 0.25. so a fire character having a fire stats is actually good. So these are the three kind of interaction with elements. Yeah, then the unaligned character power is for matching the enemy. So how is the enemy's role determined? So if we go to here, okay, but also hard. Okay, never mind. Let me change to another account. Okay, so we pick this, and then yeah, we saw this 33. I will avoid. Okay, we see a 31. So here I will have a lightning, I will fight a 31. Let's wait. So you see the enemy has a 8,396 power. So whatever the enemy roll will be plus minus 10% of that. Did I save it? No, I mean the enemy roll, let me just do another battle. So here, this 29, this enemy has a 7861, and then my power, like I say, you can simply calculate yourself. So this weapon is around 2.3, my power will be 2.3 multiplied by 3.6. So 2.3 multiplied by 3600. So this is my character power. 8,280, and then I was fighting something that is relatively easy because I have 8,280, and then he has only 7,861. So I have a original advantage over him already. So he's of a very low experience, and then this to make things worse, he's my weakness, so I can actually fight him. And this is going to be a definite victory. I don't even need a simulator to tell me this. Yeah, so here how we determine is that, okay, unaligned determines the enemy during our matching phase. So we want to meet a higher enemy or stronger enemy, which is, I say, 31 and 32. So we get a higher payout. So we also notice that, okay, a stronger weapon, see here is where, not very clear. I mean, there's a formula here, but okay. Like what we get in the matching phase is, okay, if you get a stronger weapon, we also get more money. Like for example, if I were to, I earn like 0.578 skill using a good weapon, now I change to a lousy weapon. Oh, there is no lousy, okay, this is the lousiest weapon. So if I choose a lousy weapon on the same 29 XP, just now the other monster is also 29 XP, I will fight this. So we save this number, 0.0578. Okay, 0.0578, that is our earning on a 29 XP good sword. Okay, Okay, on a good sword that we do, we get this amount. And then now I'm using a so-called lousier sword, the 39 XP monster. Lousy sword. We can see we will definitely get a lesser payout. Okay, or alternatively, you can just look at the power. The power is actually part of the formula on the payout. So you can fight something that's 10,000 power, you get more money. Fight something that is 15,000 power, you get more money. And then how they determine this power is dependent on your weapon. If you get a good weapon, you will get your power will be higher. And when your power is higher, they will match you with a stronger opponent. So when you match with a stronger opponent and you beat them, you get a higher payout. So you can see this is only 0.0516. 0.0516 is actually almost 10% lesser. Correct, this is about 10% lesser. Maybe this is $6 or $6 or whatever. $6 and then it will be like $4.50, something like that. Yep, and then we go back to the slide. Okay, matching does not take into account of your fire matching. What does this mean? That means when they calculate the weapon power, that means here, when they determine the enemy, they will use all 0.025. That means you always get an easier enemy than you're supposed to. I mean, for people using random sword, you will be just meeting something that is normal. But something, if you use something that is matching, you will get an enemy that is slightly easier. Yeah, so that's up to you lah. Then forging gives additive bonus and not multiplicative, as mentioned. And then we mentioned just now, forging is not really worth lah. I mean, since there's a forging event down, it's really not significant. And I think unless you're really rich, then you shouldn't do it. Okay, then enemy is picked relative to your power plus 10-%. So you the enemy will not be too much stronger than you. If you ever notice, the EXP range that you see are always 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 30, 33, 34, and 35. You'll never see a 36, and you will never see, actually you will see a 27, but that is a very special case. For most people, you will only see between 28 to 35. Okay, this is the XP. So based on the formula that is not shown here, this is what they call the proper match. This is what they call the proper match. That means something that is equal to you. Anything that is weaker to you will get a lower rating, and anything that is stronger than you will get a higher rating. And in general, we don't want to go for a fair fight. We always want to have a higher winning percentage, like 95% or 90%. So we always, this is our fair. Okay, this is not fair. We don't want this kind of probability. We want something that is easy. That's why I always pick a easy matchup. In fact, if it's a neutral, I would think this is risky to play also. Yeah, so we try and always fight something that is weaker to us. Yep, then in the combat phase, it's very similar. Actually, the weapon power calculation I already mentioned. The zero power, how this 0.265 and this 0.257. So, fire, power, this is a typo here. So, we have a fire, power and water. So the fire on the fire sword is a rather not fire sword, it's a fire character again. Okay, we have a 300% fire. We get a 300 on this multiplier, which is a matching element, and then a 300 power is a universal multiplier, so it's a small advantage, slightly lesser than fire but still good, so it's a some slight bonus. Okay, and then we have this that is the non-matching element. Non-matching element also give you some bonus. Okay, non-matching bonus. In fact, if a fire sword has a lot of water, this sword has some advantage for the water player as well. Yeah, but then don't do that always. Always use a fire sword on the fire character. Yep, and then so, this is a very average 5-star sword with 300, 300, 300. And then that has a multiplier of 3.25 times. And then there is the fire, the so-called the perfect weapon that we calculated just now, a 4.21 times of multiplier. Yep, we are coming to the end already, and then yeah, just a meme or just a, I mean like just a table. Okay, this I took from some of the site. I will link the site. I think it's GitHub or something. Okay, I will share this the link to this. They have a lot of useful information and also all the calculators in it. So this gives you a range of how good or how bad a 1-star sword, 2-star sword can be. Okay, but actually we actually noticed that okay the perfect 4-star sword can actually beat a lousy 5-star sword. When you look at this formula here, the best 4-star is 3.14, and the lousiest 5-star is actually only 3 times. But it is almost impossible to find it, but it can exist. Okay, so this is from the white paper. This dude mentioned, okay, 5-star is always fucking 5-star. So, okay, nothing has ever eclipsed a mighty 5-star. But, well, a 4-star can actually be stronger than a 5-star. But that will need a fully perfect 4-star and a fully lousy 5-star for this kind of thing to happen. Yep, and then so we go back to this complicated formula again. So it doesn't look so complicated anymore. Yeah, in the next video we'll share more on how to optimize our earning and some combat tricks, and also how XP, and then like if there's like in this situation, just a question for you all before the next if you have 3 enemy like this at 29 XP, which one would you fight? Yeah, so this is a question, and in this case, just imagine you are a earth character with no advantage. Which one will you fight? So imagine if there is 3, this scenario that you get these 3 enemy, which one will you pick to fight? Yep, and that is the end of this video. Bye bye.